Alright everyone, welcome back to more Horizon Zero Dawn with Rachel Bob Gaming. Bob here, bringing you some more robots. So we've literally travelled, I think it was about here, was it? To here. I fast travelled right to there and then kind of rang along. So we're going to the Sunfall City, I believe. To go find, they've got like an underground, room that we could probably get into using Aloy's face because she looks like that Elizabeth. So that's what we're gonna go do.
Sunfall. The Mad King Dran's summer palace. A bulwark of Karja might against the howling Forbidden West.
Thanks for the history lesson.
But they have no idea what lies beneath. We will learn much from this Aloy.
That's what I'm hoping.
I'm a bit worried about this place, though. Well, they're letting me in, actually, so I shouldn't really be worried. Yeah, is that a fighting arena, by any chance? Well, you never know. As long as you don't
now
put me in that ring.
Your attack on their focus network was entirely successful. Success.
Oh.
Welcome to the Citadel, Aloy. I'll check back with you.
Don't know what happened then.
Outlander, if you want to hear about today's bounties, head for the throne room. You're not going to make any shards by standing out here.
Well, we're almost there.
Means having a listen to Bahavas.
I hear the Shadow Karja are looking for one of their own. Should pay well.
By the glory of the sun revealed, behold, radiant Edaman, the one true Sun King, the light in shadow, whose will is light and whose light is law.
I command Lucian Bahavas to speak in my behalf.
By the will of Radiant Edaman does the sun glare down mercilessly upon the traitor Uthid. To the hunter who brings his head to us shall go a bounty of 500 shards.
More prisoners than royalty, don't you think?
500 shards, did you say?
Love your hair. You and I need to chat, little Huntress. The Green Tent, down in Shadowside. I'll be waiting.
Kind of busy.
We both know you're no killer for hire. Uthid is innocent. So come see me, while there's still time to save him.
So, the way in I spoke of is right behind you.
You've got to be kidding.
Not at all. And you needn't worry about the Kestrels. They'll be too busy acting important to pay attention to you.
First time in the Citadel. Gotta see the Sun Ring from on high.
But that was weird.
Why would he lead his tool?
The balustrade.
They want us
to see. It's a short drop from there.
It makes quite an impression.
All right. I don't trust when Aloy jumps, so I'll say that. Wah. No, I want to go down with. There you go. I mean, these vaults remind me of Fallout. Well, all of Fallout. I'm trying to say Fallout 4.
The other side of the tower. Look for a vent.
I see you've been here before.
Obviously. Now, it's very important that you hear what I'm about to say. I've shown you the way in, but this humble vent marks a point of no return. Before you descend into the depths here, you should be fully committed, equipped, and focused.
Yeah, pretty.
No distractions. If you have errands to run, do them first or hold your peace.
Oh, hold
my
peace.
I won't tolerate whining. Is that clear?
You'll tolerate what I give you, Silence. I didn't ask you along for the ride.
Let's go in. But I think, as you're saying that, I probably would need a lot of health. So I've got 3 plus with the berry things, well, flowers, and I've got 6 health.
I've spent a lifetime trying to uncover the secrets of this world.
So I would advise to stock up as much as possible.
Where the machines came from, how the old ones achieved such marvels only to fall into silence and death. A lifetime of failure, as year by year, decade after decade, I hit walls I could not break, doors I could never breach.
Hello.
Until Honora Huntress marched out of the savage east. And, voila, for her, all the deepest secrets of the earth were laid bare. I suspect you will have an easier time with this door than I did years ago.
So did he get in before, or is he saying he never got any further? I'm guessing he didn't get any further, because why is he sending us in?
Genetic profile confirmed. Entry authorized. Malfunction. 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 Malfunction.
Are you kidding me?
You don't hear me laughing.
Shut up. There's gotta be another way. Hey! Elizabeth Sobeck here! Requesting access!
Access request acknowledged. Root command functions available. Do you wish to proceed?
Yeah. I do! Get me through this door!
Analyzing. Primary access inoperable due to mechanical failure. Emergency venting procedure likely to circumvent blockage. Do you wish to proceed?
Yes.
Emergency venting authorized.
I underestimated you. So by now, I...
Oh, great. Well, that's gonna alert them, isn't it?
Guess you can't have everything.
That will draw attention. We won't have this place to ourselves for long now.
We? Last I checked, I was the one risking my life down here.
Yes, fine. Now, will you please get moving? There's so much to learn in less time than I'd hoped.
Alright. I'm going searching.
Welcome to Project Zero Dawn.
Always sounds like whoever's talking, they're holding their nose.
We found it.
Are you really so surprised?
Yes, I am.
Diagnostics detect multiple failures. Attempting repair, please take a seat and wait for your name to be called. A selection of beverages and snacks are available.
Woo, snacks. Trying to collect as much stuff as possible, but as quick as possible so not to keep you guys bored.
Please proceed into viewing room 1 for an important message.
What was this place?
A holographic theater.
Oh. CDN1 data intact. Initiating playback.
Welcome to Project Zero Dawn. I am General Harris, Chairman of the Joint Chiefs of Staff of the United States of America. I'm sure you've heard the rumors. That Zero Dawn is a top-secret super-weapons program. The technological miracle that will save us from the Pharaoh Plague. If Operation Enduring Victory can hold off the robots long enough. The reason I'm sure you've heard the rumors is... that I'm the one who spread them. Oh. They are all lies.
Oh.
Zero Dawn is not a super-weapons program. And it will not save us. Nothing will save us. And here's why. By the time the glitch was noticed, it was already too late. Nothing could stop the Pharaoh Plague. Nothing can. Its robots will continue to replicate and devour the biosphere. Life on Earth will be destroyed. Our planet reduced to a barren sphere. Global extinction is inevitable. No matter how many we kill, the robots just keep exponentially making more. If we had their deactivation codes, we could shut them all down. The entire swarm. But since their cryptographic protocols use polyphasic entangled waveforms, cracking a code set would take half a century. At best, we've got 16 months. Not exactly what you'd call a survival option. The destruction of a biosphere is not the sort of apocalypse you can wait out in a fallout shelter or a space station. There will be no Earth left to reclaim. Just a lifeless, toxic rock with several million Pharaoh robots on it, hibernating. waiting for something to eat. This is the horrible truth behind the lies of Operation Enduring Victory. My lies. Lies designed to inspire millions of innocents to sacrifice themselves in battle. Why?
Hope.
One reason. To buy time for you.
Oh.
And the work you will do here. Zero Day. The day that life on Earth ceases to exist is coming fast. It cannot be stopped. The hope of Zero Dawn is that something new might come after. But I will leave it to Elizabeth Sobeck to shine that thin ray of light into the darkness. Harris, out.
God, imagining delivering a message like that to... Obviously, he didn't deliver it to the whole Earth, but even to like five people.
That doesn't
crazy.
Make sense. Life on Earth didn't cease to exist.
He said it could not be stopped.
But it was. Somehow Elizabeth saved us. I've got to keep looking. Find out how she did it.
But it's weird, the robots they keep showing is...
They got in.
Rogue.
Through events.
Let nothing stop you from learning the truth.
Spread out! If it moves, kill it!
What is this place? Tomb?
Quite dark. Can I sneak up on him? How many's left? He's obviously got a big weapon. Although it looks like he's just carrying a door. Wait, it's just the biggest guy left now.
We're too close to let tribal primitives stop us now. The data points, what did they contain?
Don't want to carry this. Oh wait, actually, I think I could pick up one of these. Yeah, there you go. Oh, this way.
CD02 data intact. Initiating playback.
Never cutscene? Yes.
Elizabeth Sobeck.
You've heard the bad news, and it's all true. The Pharaoh Plague is devouring the biosphere. Life itself will cease to exist. But does that have to be the end? What if we could give life a future? What if we could build a kind of seed from which, on a dead planet, life could blossom anew? This is the aim, the hope, of Project Zero Dawn. To create a super intelligent, fully automated terraforming system and bring life back from lifelessness. What would such a system require? At its core, it would need a true AI, fully capable of making the trillions of decisions necessary to reconstitute the biosphere. An immortal guardian, devoted to the reflourishing of life. We call it Gaia. Mother Nature as an AI. But that's just the core of the system. She will need to be surrounded and empowered by a comprehensive suite of subordinate functions. Think of them as extensions of Gaia's mind, each dedicated to a specific purpose. Now, these aren't AIs, but make no mistake, each presents an engineering challenge more profound than anything the human species has ever before attempted. hardware that preserves and then gestates the billions of seeds and embryos from which life will be reborn. The construction of underground facilities to hold it all. And that's just the start. We don't have to build the entire system. The beauty of a fully automated terraforming system is that it can build itself. Now, over the days to come, you'll learn how all these functions, all these pieces that you'll be working on, fit together. How we'll race the clock to execute our harvest initiatives, write the software, build the tech and the facilities. How we'll lock it down and seal it up before the inevitable occurs. But even more important, you'll know how it doesn't end here. How Gaia will generate those deactivation codes General Harris talked about, and build the transmission arrays to broadcast them, shutting down the Pharaoh robots for good. How Gaia will not just build, but imagine any conceivable robot it needs to do its work across centuries. From detoxifying the Earth's ravaged atmosphere and poisoned seas,
what?
To the regreening of the Earth from cryopreserved seed stocks, to rewilding the Earth with animal life. And then, when all that is done, how a new generation of human beings, spawned at cradle facilities around the globe, will partake of Apollo, the vast archive of human knowledge and cultural achievement from which they will learn of us, our world. And most important, how not to repeat our mistakes. It's not an impossible dream. It is within our grasp if we work tirelessly and stop at nothing to achieve it. We can't stop life from ending. But if you will help me, help Gaia, we can give it a future. Join me and help make that future real.
That's just crazy. Imagine being that far in technology that you can create life that can create itself and
yes.
And that means all the robots I've been taken down, they're actually the good robots.
Elizabeth did this. For life. For us. But why Hades then? If it was part of Gaia, how did it end up in the wreckage of a Pharaoh robot?
Intruder! Get her!
Come on, Jen!
Whatever you do, don't die now.
Oh, the Archive of Knowledge, what happened to that?
I'm as confused as you are. Maybe the answers lie ahead.
That hurt!
Ah, great, they all got.
Hit Edelman!
I was pressing up, I swear. Why'd you always go for the gun first? Right. Alright, downstairs we go.
Here we go. Another one of these. Need to find the right configuration.
So, then you were straight down, and then the last one was what? Right.
Done. I should check. There's a part missing.
Ah, great.
Maybe there's a storage area nearby.
Take that.
Looks intact.
faster.
That should do the trick. Now let's get that door open.
Hey, I'm done with Brett's incompetence, okay? Somehow, he managed to install an H-emitter node backwards. Everything's in reverse. I don't get paid to clean up Brett's messes. If you want it fixed, send him up to storage for a new emitter, not me. Parker out.
Right, I think. I'm terrible backwards. Could better do forwards and then down.
That did it.
Okay, that's good.
Door should have power.
Now to see what lies beyond it.
Whee! Ah, crap. That's Eclipse.
Eclipse. They're here.
Avoid contact.
Lines look good.
Gaia, it's up there. Second floor.
Can you reach it?
So much for avoiding contact.
Well, don't mind the Eclipse, because there's always one. There he is, with the backpack. Oh, shit. I don't think you can teach that. I think you're just born with that.
Don't let it end like this.
Can't see.
Room's clear. For a moment, anyway.
Hello, I'm Marco Shen, and this is Hephaestus.
Hi.
As the name might tip you off, this is going to be the subordinate function that Gaia will use to make lots and lots of robots. Her personal forge. Except.
I do think this was real, and we were this far in technology. Exactly the same thing would happen. We'd build robots, someone will call them peacekeepers, then they won't give the peace.
I think this is it. Elizabeth Sobeck's office. But it, more Eclipse.
Careful now.
Steady.
Welcome to Apollo, the collective memory of the human species and the wellspring of knowledge for future generations. I am Samina Elbaji. I was director of the International Collective Memory Institute in New Tehran. As a heritage professional, I devoted my career to the preservation of human knowledge, creating...
Oh no!
Go ahead.
You won't survive this.
Oh. Every time when I get the gun, I've got loads of treasure actually.
A game of wonders. Look around, see if anything is left.
Let's see. There we go. That's what I wanted.
Failsafe protocol, the ultimate killer app. Now, I know what you're thinking. The purpose of Gaia is to resurrect life. So why give her a subordinate function, only purpose of which is to wipe out life all over again?
Let me guess, just in case it goes wrong.
Looks like the only way onwards.
Welcome to Eleuthia, the crown and king of Gaia's subordinate functions. For it is by Eleuthia that the human race will continue to exist.
Machines to
I am Patrick Rojak Klein, the Alpha in charge of this program. Now let one.
I don't really mind that much.
Elizabeth said a new.
I don't want to hang around too much.
Of humans.
She already see a lot of me just running around.
She did.
But we'll find out more about Hades.
Oh, Mother Mountain.
As it goes on.
It was one of them?
There's a...
That's
what benefit from antilopony morphologies. Low campered forms show superior low
You will undergo a brief period of unconsciousness during relocation to Prime and final instatement.
Elizabeth, may I speak outside protocol?
When you're back up and running with the new site, we will bring the subordinate functions online and...
Elizabeth, I detect...
All right, let's access it.
Registry master file.
Intact?
Yeah. No signs of corruption.
Then what are you waiting for? Copy the file.
Download it.
I can restore the registry at the hatch inside Allmother. Open it. Go inside.
And grasp the secrets within.
Where I was born. Maybe who gave birth to me.
Who? Are you really so naive? There will be no who waiting for you there, Aloy. Whatever birthed you into the world was a what, not a who.
You bastard.
Oh no, I had a legitimate birth. It's you, Aloy, who are the creation of a machine. But what kind of machine and why? Why were you created?
Ah, crap.
Eclipse.
You need to get out of there. What you found is too valuable. You're too valuable.
Pretty sure the Green Goblin did the same thing.
Still alive. Good. I have a more suitable death in mind for you, child.